Yes, good morning, class. Please let me know first if you can hear my voice and can see my screen clearly. Please let me know, everyone, so that we will start the class. Yes, Iman, Faliha, Hafsa, Maida, Shiza, Yusra Fawad, who is she? Please rename yourself. I think this is Fawzia Fawad. Please rename yourself. Yes, okay. So let's start the class. Today we are going to revise or reinforce chapter viruses, bacteria and cyanobacteria. Okay, viruses, bacteria and cyanobacteria. So this is the reinforcement class, and just after the class you will be getting the reinforcement quiz from this chapter. Please must attempt the quiz, and we will also discuss if there will be any problem or anything you won't understand during this session. We will start or we will discuss it in the school. Okay, so microorganism as a heterogeneous group of organism. First of all, please start writing the answer of the microorganism. Define microorganism. What does it mean? Yes, start writing the definition of microorganisms. Yes, Maida, Faliha, Hafsa, Walaikum Assalam, Faliha. Today, Fatima is not present. Walaikum Assalam, Fatima, how are you? Okay, beta, I start writing the definition of microorganisms. What do we mean by microorganisms? And also, what's your concept about the heterogeneous group? I'm still waiting for the answer. Yes, class. Is there anybody writing the answer of the question? What is meant by microorganism? How do we define microorganisms? An organism which cannot be seen without microscope. Which cannot be seen by our naked eye. Without our naked eye would be wrong answer. An organism which cannot be seen by, not without, okay, by our naked eyes is called microorganism. We use microscope to see them. Okay, organisms which are seen by microscope. Maida, write the complete answer. Yes. Okay, Fatima, which can be seen by microscopes. Yes, right. Okay, good. Good, everyone. And heterogeneous group of organisms means different types of organisms which belong to different class, phylum or kingdom, or as well as we can see their sizes are different, their structures are different, so they are called heterogeneous group of organisms. So the minute living organism which cannot be seen without the help of microscope are called microorganisms. Okay, at times they are also called microscopic organisms. Now next is, they form heterogeneous group which include viruses, bacteria, cyanobacteria. How do we pronounce it? Cyano, C-Y-A, cyanobacteria. Okay, please pronounce it correctly, cyanobacteria. Quickly, we say cyanobacteria, but we skip the pronunciation of A. So it is cyanobacteria. At times I also influence, I speak cyano, but it is cyano. Okay, right. Next is protozoa. Okay, these are all the heterogeneous group and they all belong to microorganism. They are all microorganisms. Okay, next is bacteria and cyanobacteria are prokaryotes and studied under kingdom prokaryote, Monera. Prokaryote, kingdom prokaryote is also called Monera, kingdom Monera. Bacteria and cyanobacteria are prokaryotes, okay? Without true nucleus, means no true nucleus is present in bacteria and cyanobacteria. Next is rest of the organisms are eukaryotes and studied under Protoctista. It is also called Protista. Protista or Protoctista. So only bacteria and cyanobacteria are prokaryotes and rest of the microorganisms are eukaryotes. Means in them true nucleus is present. Bacteria are heterotroph as well as autotroph. Heterotroph means they cannot synthesize their own food. Autotroph, they can synthesize their own food. Okay. Auto means by self, by the, on their own. Hetero means cannot. Okay, cannot prepare their own food. Cyanobacteria and algae are autotrophs because they have green coloring material, chlorophyll, due to which they can carry out photosynthesis. Next is protozoa are heterotroph. Protozoa, all the amoeba, paramecium, they belong to phylum protozoa and they are heterotroph. Since they lack green coloring material, chlorophyll, that's why they cannot synthesize their own food. They depend on other organisms for their food. Viruses lie between, somewhere lie between living and non-living organisms. So we can say viruses are the link between living and non-living organisms. Okay, at times they show the properties of living things, at times they show the properties of non-living things. They are obligate parasites, right? Now next is tobacco mosaic virus, TMV. Tobacco mosaic virus, it's a disease occurring in tobacco plant leaves caused by unknown, its cause is unknown earlier before the discovery or construction of electron microscope. Later, when the electron microscopes were developed, the scientists or biologists, they studied the reason and they studied the organism which caused this disease, and they came to the conclusion that this disease is caused by virus. Earlier, they were in conception that this disease is caused by bacteria, something bacteria-like or smaller than bacteria, okay? B mein kya hai? What B mein kya hai? Kya, Abdul Rahman, I can't get your question. What do you mean by B mein kya hai? B, achha, okay. This question, this A is showing the healthy leaf, and this B picture, this picture is showing the these black dots or the change of color. It shows the disease, tobacco mosaic disease, TMV. The plant leaf is carrying out TMV. Okay, this is the picture of healthy leaf. This is the picture of infected leaf. Got it? Infected leaf by TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. So when the electron microscopes were developed or constructed, scientists or biologists, they learned that this TMV or this type of disease in plant leaf, in tobacco plant leaf, it is due to the infection from something very smaller than bacteria, and the scientist Ivanovsky, he named them the microorganisms, he named these microorganisms viruses, okay? Now, structure of virus. All viruses contain the following two components, a nucleic acid genome in the head region, that is, they contain RNA and DNA, ribonucleic acid and deoxyribonucleic acid. We have learned about RNA and DNA in detail during the class. and a protein capsid that covers the genome. This is the capsid. It covers the genome, and this is the glycoprotein, and the completely it is covered by a protein coat. Okay, together this is called nucleocapsid. In addition, many animal viruses contain lipid envelope. Viruses may vary in their structure. Now look at the structure. Here you can see the different structures of virus or their shapes. First one is the polyhedral adenovirus. Adenovirus, it happens in animals and human beings. Okay, next is influenza virus. The shape of influenza virus is this. Influenza virus, we almost everyone has been suffered from influenza virus means when we are having cough or flu. This influenza virus infect the human beings. So it is spherical, round in shape. Helical, this helical structure, it is tobacco mosaic virus. Okay, this is the virus which cause disease in the tobacco plant leaves. Complex virus, this type of a structure, this is called bacteriophage. Bacteriophage virus infects bacteria. Right, if it is written bacteriophage, don't think that it is a bacteria. It is a virus which infects bacteria. Right, bacteriophage virus, it infects bacteria. Spherical virus, it is influenza virus. Adeno polyhedral structure, this is adenovirus. These two infects the human and animals, human beings mostly. Now, why viruses are considered as living or non-living? Can anybody give me one reason why we considered viruses as living? First, give me the reason for considering the virus as living thing. Yes, hurry up, start writing. Talha, Zimal, please start writing. Class, Anita, Iman, Faliha, Fatma, why we consider they have ability to reproduce? Yeah, good. They have ability, yes. Right, Shiza, any other reason? Any other reason? What about mutation? What is mutation? Mutation ka meaning, anybody can tell me? Anita? Yes, everybody is writing the same reason. I want different reasons. Yes, mutation means food. No. Mutation means change or change in the sequence of protein. Mutation means change in the sequence of. You haven't, Medha, have you? Yes, without a host cell, the virus, unlike other living organisms. Yes, Hamza, right. Mutation means viruses undergo mutation. If you remember, those who have attended my first online class upon viruses, I told you that, yes, Anita, right. I told you that viruses undergo mutation, and the coronavirus is the mutated form of SARS virus. SARS virus came in 2002-2003 in Asia Pacific region. Right now, yes, Hamza, okay. Now it is mutated, and coronavirus is the mutated form of SARS virus. Okay, mutation means a change of. I'm going to write the definition of mutation. Change of protein sequence in DNA. RNA is called mutation. M-U-T-A-T-I-O-N, mutation. Please write down the definition. Change of protein sequence in RNA or DNA is called mutation. And replication means replication. Replication means producing the exact copies. Producing the exact copies means photocopying. We have something original, and if we take photocopy of it, this is called the replication. So viruses, they undergo replication by producing their exact copies. In every form, produce exact copies. Okay, so I have written the definition of mutation and replication here. Please copy it down. Okay, now first reason, they reproduce through replication. Second reason, they undergo mutation. These two are the reasons of why we consider viruses as living things. Another reason, they have nucleic acid made up of DNA and RNA. Okay, so first reason, they reproduce through replication and undergo mutation. Third reason, they have nucleic acid core, which is made up of DNA and RNA. Nucleic acid, inside the DNA and RNA, the nucleic acid core, it contains proteins which are arranged, 20 amino acids or proteins, which are arranged in different sequence. If their sequence has changed, this is called mutation. Okay. Now, second question is that why they are considered non-living, why the viruses are considered non-living. We have three reasons. They can crystallize themselves, they have non-cellular structure, they are inactive outside the host cell. Means if the coronavirus, let's take example of coronavirus. If coronavirus is non-living when it is outside the host body, when it is outside the human body. Okay, it can, if it is lying somewhere on some metallic object or some paper bag or some paper or tissue paper, it is non-living. Okay, until or unless it comes in contact with the human cells, human body. When it comes in contact with the living cells or human body, it starts behaving like living thing. Before that, when it is lying somewhere on non-living thing, if it is lying somewhere on non-living thing, it behaves like non-living. When it enters into living body, it starts behaving like living thing. So reason for considering it non-living is crystallized, non-cellular structure, inactive outside the host cell. This is called the inactive outside the host cell. This property is called obligate parasite. Okay, obligate parasite. Somewhere someone is saying something. Okay, now next is, so we can say the viruses are the link between living and non-living. Okay, this is the only organism which is a link between living and non-living. Please keep remember it. Now, rod-shaped bacterium, this is the bacteria which has the shape of a rod-like structure, and this is called the rod-shaped bacterium. Can anybody tell me who first time observed the bacteria? Name of the scientist who first time observed the bacteria. Yes, start writing the name of the scientist. And why they are called unicellular prokaryotes. Start writing the answer why they are. Yes, the spelling is wrong, but I got it that what you are intended to write. Yes, start writing the answer, Bita. The name of the scientist who first time observed the bacteria as simplest living organisms. Yes, Fatma, the spelling is wrong. Look into the book. Look into the book, Hamza. Yes, who first time is, just a minute, Hamza, let me write the question. Who first time, name the scientist who observed the bacteria for the first time. It is living. Yeah. Anita, yes, right. Leuvenhoek. Leeuwenhoek. The name of the scientist is Leeuwenhoek. Right. Okay. So Here is the structure of rod-shaped bacterium. The structure is divided into two parts. On the right-hand side, there are some organelles are written, means the parts of the cells are written, which are always present. These structures are always present in every bacteria. Number one, first is cell wall. Number two, cell membrane. Number three, ribosomes. Number four, food reserve. Then cytoplasm, it is a jelly-like substance. It covers the entire cell. It fills the entire cell. Then the DNA. DNA is the reproductive material in the rod-shaped bacterium. Okay. Next to cell wall, here the cytoplasm. Cell membrane, cell surface membrane, it is also called. It is a thin outer layer of the plasma membrane. And since the mitochondria or other necessary structures are not present in prominent structures are not present in bacteria, so in the absence of mitochondria, cell membrane performs the function of respiration. The cell membrane, it performs the function of respiration. In our cells, we have mitochondria. Our body cells, each body cell contains mitochondria, which helps the cell to respire. Means mitochondria is the respiratory organ of the cell. Since bacteria, they do not have any mitochondria, that's why their respiration is carried out by this cell surface membrane. Okay. It acts as a selective membrane. It allows the movement of material in and out of the cell. Okay. So next is cytoplasm. It entirely fills the cell and it is granular, since because different structures are present in the cytoplasm. Right. Next is you people need to practice the diagram a lot, whether if you feel easy that you can draw this rod-shaped bacterium very well, please practice it more. If you want to draw the structure of virus bacteriophage, please practice it a lot so that you can get the full marks in the diagrams along with the labeling. Right. Next is types of bacteria. I have given you to learn the structure of vibrios and spirilla. There are four different types of bacteria according to their shapes: cocci, bacilli, spirilla, and vibrocoma. Look at the structure of cocci. Cocci is spherical in structure and there is no flagella. It is non-flagellated. Bacillus, they are rectangular in shape and they have a small hair-like structure called flagella. Okay, which help the bacillus in movement. Next is spirilla. Spirilla, they have several different flagella or flagellum, and due to this, it has a screw-shaped structure, and due to this, it is called spirilla. Spiral or screw-shaped structure. Okay, spiral or screw-shaped structure. Cork screw-shaped structure, that's why it is called spirilla. Vibrocoma. The structure of the vibro bacteria is comma shape. The sign in English or sign of comma, its shape is comma. Okay, they are slightly curved or comma shaped, and they are flagellated. At times, they are flagellated. Abdul Rahman, if you will unmute yourself again, I will expel you from the class. Please remember it. Yes, cocci, bacilla, spirilla, vibrocoma. So, cocci, they are spherical in shape, bacillus, rectangular in shape, spirilla, spiral shape, and they are mostly coil or screw shape. Vibros, they have slightly curved shape or comma shaped structure. I'm not asking you any question. I ask you not to unmute yourself. you are distracting my class. Okay, types of bacteria according to their mode of nutrition. Now this part is very, very important. Bacteria, they are autotrophic and heterotrophic. Autotrophic, they are again divided into chemoautotrophic or photoautotrophic. Okay, chemoautotrophic and photoautotrophic, they have a special green coloring pigments due to which they carry out photosynthesis and they produce their own food. The definition of autotrophic is that they are able to synthesize their organic food from inorganic substances. They can use carbon dioxide as a sole carbon source or they fix carbon. Heterotrophic, they cannot synthesize their own food or they are unable to manufacture their own food and they are dependent on external source, means on some other living or non-living sources. Heterotrophic are of two types, parasitic, those who dependent on other plants or animals or human beings to obtain their food. Saprophytic, they act upon or they are dependent on dead organic material. Okay, next are symbiotic. Symbiotic means they are dependent on other living organism, but in return they also provide them with some benefit. Now let's learn that autotrophic are the bacteria which can synthesize organic compounds from simple inorganic substances. Photosynthetic bacteria, they have pigments very similar to chlorophyll. They carry out photosynthesis, very simple. Okay, if in exams it comes define photosynthetic bacteria, so your answer should be they contain these type of bacteria, they have or they contain pigments like chlorophyll and they carry out photosynthesis. Chemosynthetic bacteria, they synthesize organic compound by oxidation of iron, nitrogen, hydrogen or sulfur. Next is heterotrophic bacteria. Now heterotrophic bacteria, parasitic bacteria, first one, parasitic bacteria live inside the tissue of other living organism and obtain food from their host. Like they, some bacteria, they live in our body. They are dependent on our tissues to obtain their food, but they are not providing us any benefit. Rather, they are damaging our tissues. Okay, this is called the parasitic bacteria. Next is saprophytic bacteria. They get their food from dead organic matter by utilizing dead bodies through their enzymes. So saprophytic bacteria, they act on dead plants or animals or human beings. After their death, they act upon these dead organic matter and utilize them for their food. Okay, utilize them for their food. So next is symbiotic bacteria, found associated with other living organisms and obtain food from their host. Means these bacteria, they live in our body, in our intestine. Look, this is the diagram of our digestive system and it shows that in our intestine, this is the intestine, a small intestine, and they live in our intestine. These are the four different types of bacteria, four different shapes of bacteria. First one, these are cocci, bacilli, or cocci and bacilli, they live in our body, in our alimentary canal, and they produce some important substances in our body, but at the same time they feed upon our tissues. Means they live on our tissues, they obtain food from our tissues, but at the same time they produce vitamin K in our intestine on their own. So this vitamin K is necessary for our growth and development, for the clotting of blood. So these symbiotic bacteria, they are not only living in our body, in our intestine, and only feed upon our tissues or our cells, but at the same time they also benefited us. They also provide us with some benefit by producing vitamin K in our body naturally. Understood? Parasitic bacteria, they live in our body, but they do not provide us any benefit. Saprophytic bacteria, they do not live on they do not take food or live on living bodies. They act on dead organic matter. Okay, they live on dead organic matter, obtain food from them. Symbiotic bacteria, they live in our alimentary canal. They obtain food from our intestine, from our blood, but in return, they benefit us by providing or producing vitamin K naturally. Okay, importance of bacteria. Agriculture bacteria, saprophytic bacteria decompose dead animals and plants and making the soil fertile. What happens when animals or plants, they die, or human beings also, when they die, these bacteria act upon them, decompose or break down the dead bodies, whether the plants or animals or human beings. And when they are died, different minerals are produced after the death or decomposition of dead plants or animals. Different minerals are being produced and they are added up in our soil to make it fertile, like phosphorus, like calcium, or different minerals. Okay, our body, the human beings, animals, or plants, when they are die, saprophytic bacteria take food from them and decompose them. Decompose means ke pura achi tarah se tod phod dena, bilkul khatam kar dena, ke the flesh is also gone, only the bones are left, which are also turned into phosphorus or calcium, and they are added fertile to our soil. Okay, yes, Abdul Bilad, medicine, yes, Bilad. Right, I'm coming on that side. Alimentary canal bacteria, they produce an enzyme cellulase in herbivores. Okay, in herbivorous animals, if they are these type of bacteria, they are present in herbivores. Herbivores are those organisms which feed upon plants only. Okay, those animals which feed only on plants. So in herbivores, alimentary canal bacteria produce the enzyme cellulase and help them to digest the food. Some bacteria are present in the gut of human beings to produce vitamin K. This is the type of symbiotic bacteria. This is the type of saprophytic bacteria. Next is, again, industrial bacteria used to convert milk into curd and cheese, sugarcane juice into vinegar. So industrial bacteria are also the type of symbiotic bacteria. Industrial bacteria, alimentary canal bacteria, they are the types of symbiotic bacteria, because symbiotic bacteria in industry, on industrial level, they convert the milk into curd and cheese. Sugarcane juice can also be turned into vinegar by the help of industrial bacteria, symbiotic bacteria. Yes. Enzyme cellulose, कितने होते हैं herbivores में, क्या मतलब कितने, कोई numbers नहीं होते, they are continuously like saliva in your mouth, आप उसको numbers में count कर सकते हैं, can you count the saliva in your mouth? Abdul Rahman, let me know. Okay. Next is medicinal bacteria. Valuable antibiotic drugs have been obtained from bacteria. Means there are several antibiotics which are being obtained from bacteria, which are helpful for treating the different diseases, the different type of diseases, and they are called medicinal bacteria. They are helpful in on medical side, right? So we have four importance of bacteria, and they are agriculture bacteria, alimentary canal bacteria, industrial bacteria, and medicinal bacteria. Got it? Understood, everyone? Is this clear? Now, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria. Characters of cyanobacteria. Blue-green algae and prokaryotic. Occur alone or in colony. Means at times they occur a single cell of, or the single alone algae or in colony. Mostly they occur in the form of colony. That's why you can see the layer of algae, blue-green algae, on the water surface. Found in fresh water, mostly double-layered cell wall. You can see double-layered cell wall. Then protoplasm is differentiated into chromoplasm and centroplasm. Plasma membrane or protoplasm is differentiated into chromoplasm and centroplasm. Okay, chromoplasm and centroplasm. Next is reproduce only by asexual reproduction. Okay, they can reproduce themselves by asexual reproduction. Now, reinforcement questions. Beta, start writing the answers of these questions. We have already discussed microorganisms, so leave it. How do we see viruses? Means by which method we can observe viruses? Write down the answer. Just 2 minutes are left. Please start writing the answers of these questions quickly. How do we see the viruses? Yes, electron microscope. Good. Yes, Hamza. They are microbes or microscopic. Yes, Abdul Rahman. Electron microscope. Electron. Okay. Which microorganism is the link between living and non-living thing? Yes. Good, everyone. Which? Question number 3. Yes. Good. Good, Anita. Bilal, you are writing cyanobacteria. No. If you are answering for question number 3, this is wrong. Virus is the link between, I have just repeated it several times, that virus is the link between living and non-living, because at times they show the characters of living things, at times they show the characters of non-living things. Okay, so virus is the, I'm writing one more question here. Nostoc belongs to, write down the answer. By the time I'm marking your attendance. Yes, start writing the answers. Bacteria. Which bacteria? Bilal, now again you are writing the wrong answer. Name 3 types of heterotrophic. What is the function of elementary canal bacteria? Blue, green algae, Fatma. Name 3 types of. You guys are writing the answer of this question. Question number 4. What is the function of elementary canal bacteria in our. It produces. This type of bacteria produces vitamin K in our body. The answer is vitamin K. Name 3 types of heterotrophic bacteria. Parasitic, heterotrophic bacteria, parasitic, symbiotic, saprophytic. These are the 3 types of heterotrophic bacteria. Main function of the elements is to nourish the body. Beta, Hamza, you took this question wrong. I was asking what is the function of elementary canal bacteria in our. Hello? Yes, the function of elementary canal bacteria is to produce vitamin K in our body. It's to produce vitamin K in our body. And have you got it? The function of elementary canal bacteria is to produce vitamin K in our body, in our intestine. And 3 types of heterotrophic bacteria are, 3 types of heterotrophic bacteria are parasitic bacteria, autotrophic bacteria parasitic bacteria, saprophytic bacteria, and the last one is the symbiotic bacteria. Yes. Yeah. Industrial bacteria, vitamin K kyun karega? Industrial bacteria converts milk into curd or cheese. Yes, Fatma. Yes, Fatma. Tell me. Rahman, make it correct. Industrial bacteria does not produce vitamin K in your body. Industrial bacteria convert milk into cheese. Nostoc belongs to cyanobacteria. I was asking that Nostoc belongs to which group? Nostoc belongs to cyanobacteria. The answer is cyanobacteria. Okay, beta. Now it's time to say goodbye. Okay. And please must attempt the quiz, which is going to be posted right after the class. Okay. सो अल्लाह हाफिज़, अल्लाह हाफिज़ एवरीवन।